Hey, it's Colin here from Photoshop Cafe, and this week I'm going to show you 5 things that you didn't know were inside of Photoshop. So here's the thing, I've been using Photoshop for about 20 years, I'm afraid to admit it, and there's a ton of things in there, and I was recently working at a booth at WPPI, and I had someone come and ask me a question. And I was like, wow, I actually forgot that feature was even in Photoshop. So what I figured I would do is I'd do a special episode, which is what we're gonna do this week. And I'm actually gonna look at 5 things in here that I'd actually forgotten or maybe just haven't used a lot and certainly haven't covered really in my tutorials here, at least not the ones I have on YouTube. So let's go through them and have a look at the 5 things that you didn't know that you can do in Photoshop. And the very first one is the transformer selection. All right, we want to make a selection around the lens of this camera. So we're going to grab our marquee, it's our elliptical marquee, and we're going to pull it down. And if you hit the space bar, you can move this around while you're drawing it. So we can get the height about right, but if you look at this, there's no way. Let's make it a little wider. We're going to try and get it as good as we can. But notice there's no way to make this fit in here because this is tilted at an angle and you just can't do that with the selection. So what we're going to do is go up to the select, and then we're going to go down to the transform selection, and now we can rotate our selection, and we can work this selection just like you would with any shape or any object inside of Photoshop. We're just using the free transform, but it's working on the selection. So as you can see, we're able to just change the angle and everything, and I'm just going to apply it. This is just rough, and we're just going to create a new layer quickly and apply a mask to it. And let's just drop something in here just for fun. So we're just gonna grab this eye, drag that in here. Let's resize it. Let's just Control T or Command T for free transform. And of course we know that works on an image, but now we know it works on a selection. So what you can do with this mask too is just grab this mask and drag it up to that new layer, and we're now using it on that layer. Of course you could double click on the mask here and add a feather and just kind of soften this and start to blend it in. So the second thing that we're gonna look at, number 2, is gonna be show all. So you may or may not be aware that when you have your canvas, which is the area that you see and around it is known as a pasteboard, when you expand an image or a layer and it goes outside those bounds, it doesn't cut it off. It actually exists in the pasteboard, but you don't see it.
So here we go, we've got a picture as a portrait, and then I'm gonna grab a landscape, and maybe we wanna composite the two together. So let me just click and drag this into here, and I'm just gonna just apply it there as a different color depth and all that stuff. We'll drop it behind our cutout, and we're just gonna drop the size of our cutout here a little bit. So let's just select it, and I'm just gonna hit Control T for free transform again, and then just go in here. All right, so we've got a couple of things that we need to do. One of them is I wanna show the whole thing. So we could, you know, choose the crop tool if we want, and we could actually crop it out. That's another way of doing this. Notice that you can see it there when I hit the crop tool. There are pixels there. So we can drag it out and recrop it, or we can just simply use this command here. Let's just go up under image, and under image we're going to choose to reveal all, and now it shows everything. We've still got a little bit of transparency at the top and bottom. We can get rid of that by going to image. We're going to go to trim and hit transparent pixels, and boom, there we go. Now we can add our drop shadows and do all our blending.
Number 3. What about when you're working on a multi-layered project and then you want to be free to experiment?
All right, here's a photograph that I actually shot last night. This is a 115 image aerial HDR panorama that I shot with my drone. So you can also, you know, just check it out on my Instagram or Facebook, and daily I post a new picture, just so you know. And right now I'm just in Photoshop and I'm experimenting with some different kind of toning and stuff like that with some different layers. Maybe I want to experiment in a different direction, but I don't want to overwrite this image in case I want to keep it. Now, as you can imagine, this is a huge image. We're only looking, you know, it's almost 11,000 pixels across. So I could choose File, Save As, and then start experimenting with that new image. But it's creating a huge image. So I could save copies of it, or I could do this. If we just go down to our, let's go under Window here, and what we want to do is open up the History panel. So here's our History panel. And what I can do is if I just go and click on this little option here, this will create a brand new document. Right now it's just called a stamp visible, because what it is, it's literally the same document. And notice here, all the layers are still here. So it's identical in size, color space, everything. Nothing's changed. But what it does is allows me to experiment a little bit. In fact, I can create a few of these. And the cool thing is, this is not even saved. So I can experiment with these different ones. And if I get one I like, I can save it. Otherwise, I just click there, don't save it, and away it goes. And I haven't filled up my hard drive.
Number four, the Quickmask tool is incredibly useful. I don't know if you use it or not, but essentially you can toggle between a brush and a selection. So it's a way of brushing on selections.
Sometimes you're making selections, and we can be doing things like here. Let me just select some of the red on this car. And I just want to just quickly do this. And, you know, I might want to clean this up a little bit. And one of the tools I like to use for cleaning it up is a quick mask. So I can hit the Q key or click down here for quick mask. So let's hit the Q key. And you can see there's our mask there. Now, there's only one problem with this. Notice it's the same color as the car. So it's very hard to tell what's going on. So what we can do is we can change the color of quick mask. Double click the quick mask, and then we're going to change it from red to yellow and click OK. So now our quick mask is yellow, so now we can see we've missed some little bits there, and I could grab my brush and I could go in and just kind of paint in there and you know, clean up my selection that way. So that's using the quick mask, changing the color of it.
And finally, number five, this is a question that a gentleman asked me. I was working at Adobe's booth at WPPI, and he asked me about droplets. Droplets? I haven't used droplets since Photoshop 5.5. Not CS, but 5.5. Well, actually, it came out in Image Ready, and then it was added into Photoshop 5.5, and then just kind of kept going from there. And they're still there. They're still alive and well, even though sometimes it's a little hard to tell. But they're kicking, and they're great. So droplets are basically actions that you can put on your desktop, and you can drop a photograph into that action, and it will perform that action without Photoshop even being open.
Okay, so here's our last one. Do you ever use Actions? I know people use Actions all the time. They're a great way of saving time. In fact, I've got Actions in here, some that I've created, and some, you know, that come with Photoshop. So what if I don't want to necessarily have to go into Photoshop all the time to run this action? Well, check this out. If you go to File, and then you choose to Automate, go down to Create Droplet. Now, we're going to create our droplet, and I'm going to drop it here into my desktop. And here's one I've got, Luma masks, that I like to do with luminosity masking. So what I can do is I can tell it what I want it to do. So there is where we're saving it. It's called Luma mask. And we're going to grab our Photoshop Cafe set. And then we've got some different ones. I'm going to grab my Luma mask action and then just click OK. And what's happened there? If we go to our desktop, look at that. We've got our Luma mask droplet. So this is known as a droplet. You can save it in any location you want. So what we're going to do here is I'm just going to grab a photo. Let's grab, say, or maybe we could grab this particular image here. And all I'm going to do is take it and I'm going to drop it into that Luma mask. Now what's happening here when it says error is just giving me an error log to tell me if there's any errors. And there were no errors there. It worked properly. So what happened? Well, let's have a look here. We can see right there, now we've got our image there inside of Photoshop. It actually brought it in there. And if we go to our channels, you'll notice all my luminosity masks are now created because it ran that action for me. So that's a great thing you can do. Drag and drop it into that little droplet, and then it will launch Photoshop and run that action for you automatically.
So I hope you enjoyed those five little tips and that they've helped you in Photoshop. Maybe you knew some of these. Maybe you didn't know any of them. Maybe you've got some tips that I didn't cover. Add a comment in the bottom. Let's get a discussion going. And don't be afraid to ask some questions, because I'm going to do some Q&As soon. And I'm going to look at the questions in the comments. And some of those I'm actually going to bring up on one of our episodes, and I'm going to answer that live. So don't forget, subscribe to Photoshop Cafe. I'm adding a new tutorial every week, at least one a week. And if you're a subscriber, this will come directly to you. It takes nothing. Just click that subscribe button right now, wherever it is. It's either there or it's there. I don't actually know where it is. I get my left and right mixed up sometimes. But just click that big, huge, ugly red button, and you'll become a subscriber, and you're going to get new episodes every single week. And also don't forget to like this and share it with your friends. And we've got a ton more tutorials. Check out our channel here. And also jump onto photoshopcafe.com where we have hundreds of free tutorials. Until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.